नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ आवर चैप्टर डाइजेशन, वेयर इन LP1 वी केम टू नो द डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स प्लेइंग एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द डाइजेशन प्रोसेस, एंड इन LP2 वी केम टू नो द मेन रोल ऑफ टीथ, टंग एंड सलाइवा इन द फूड मटेरियल. सो नाउ इन LP3 वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द ट्रूली प्रोसेस ऑफ डाइजेशन. ओके, so let us start our class. The main aim of our today's class is to learn how each organ of the digestive system helpful to digest the food material. So the keywords here in this topic are your churn. Churn means it is to move or shake something with a lot of force.
Churn, to move or shake something with force.
Now the second keyword that you are going to learn, that is digestive juice. Digestive juice means it is a liquid which helps in the process of digestion.
Digestive juice, a liquid which helps in digestion.
Okay, so now let us, before starting the class, let us have a look on a small video.
Digestive organs have different functions. Esophagus pushes food. Into stomach, which releases digestive juices that partially digest food. Food goes to small intestine, where digestive juices from liver and pancreas help digest food. Undigested food enters large intestine and is sent out through anus. Digestive organs.
Yes, so here you are able to see various digestive organs that are playing a vital role in the digestion process. So in our earlier block we came to know that organs like your tongue, teeth and saliva that are present in the mouth region helpful in digesting and making the food into a smaller piece, half digested or partially digested food, that is called your bolus. Now that bolus, you are swallowing it. So when you will swallow the bolus, then now that bolus, it passes through a pipe-like structure that is called esophagus, which is meant for only traveling of the food from mouth to stomach region. So when the food, it is traveled from mouth to stomach region in a systemic traveling, that is a rhythmic contraction and relaxation that is shown in the esophagus, and that movement we are calling it as a peristaltic movement. That movement what we are calling it as a peristaltic movement. So due to peristaltic movement, food, it is pushed in the esophagus and then it reaches to a muscular bag-like structure that is called your stomach, where in the stomach food is stored for nearly about 4 hours. So now the stomach walls, it will keep on going in a contraction and relaxation state, due to which churning of food material occurs. Churning means mixing of food material thoroughly, and the stomach walls, even they are secreting a juice, digestive juice, that is called gastric juice, which helpful to digest the food materials properly. So at first the bolus, when you will swallow, it travels through the complete length of your esophagus by peristaltic movements, and then it comes to the stomach, where the food, it is acted by the digestive juice like your gastric juice, and it is churned properly, and then it is digested a bit, or it is digested halfly. Such a partially digested food material near the stomach, it is called your chyme. Now that chyme, it is entering from stomach to small intestine. So whenever the food it is entering into the small intestine, liver starts secreting its juices into the intestine, and even the pancreas also starts your secretions, that is your digestive juices called pancreatic juice, into the intestine, where the intestine itself it is secreting the digestive juices. Means intestine, small intestine is a part where the liver juices that are called your bile juice, the pancreatic juices that is your call your pancreatic juice, that is your pancreatic juice, and then if you will see the intestine itself, it is releasing intestinal juices. All these three are helpful in the complete digestion of food, and the digested food is now then immediately absorbed into the blood. Means small intestine, it is the most important part where the complete digestion of food material occurs, and then it is absorbed into the blood. Remember this word, small intestines. It is a place where the complete digestion of food material is occurring. At the same time, absorption of the food into the blood also takes place in the small intestine. Now, the remaining parts, that's your large intestine. It is a part where the undigested particle travels throughout the length of the large intestine and then stored in the rectum region for a small duration, and through the anus the food it is sent out of the body. So how are the things used in this activity are similar in the process of digestion? Of course, the things that are used here, that is a straw that is helpful to send the master food material, which is acting like the oesophagus, and a zip pouch that is acting like a stomach, and the cloth that is absorbing, which acts like a small intestine of our body. How are the different digestive organs helpful in the process of digestion? So different digestive organs, they are helpful, especially if you will take the esophagus, it is helpful to allow the food to pass from mouth to stomach by peristaltic movements, and the stomach, it is secreting digestive juices like gastric juice, which is partially helping to digest the food material. And the third one, that is a small intestine, where the secretions of liver and the secretions of your pancreas acts on the food material and digests the food completely in the small intestine region, and then it is absorbed into the blood. Now the undigested food material, it goes from small intestine to large intestine and it is defecated out of the body. Yes, why does the food, it will not travel back? This is one more important question. Why the food, it will not travel back, though the organs of the digestive system are, how they are helping to prevent the backward movement? So here if you will see, in the digestive system, a very specialized muscular organs like gates, means just like walls, they are blocking at each and every organ level, which are totally preventing the backward movement of food. So now let us complete our worksheet, children. So in our worksheet, at first they are asking, tick the correct sentence. The first sentence, that is, food goes from mouth to small intestine through oesophagus. So it is wrong, because it goes from mouth to stomach. Now the second statement, undigested food becomes solid waste in the large intestine. This is totally correct, because when the undigested food it is passing through the large intestine, the water and the mineral content that is present in the undigested food, it is absorbed by it and becomes and that undigested food becomes solidified. Now the third one, food goes from mouth to stomach through oesophagus. This is correct. So now the second question, if you will see, complete the table. So in the table they are given some digestive organs and how these organs are helpful in digestion. Stomach is a part where the food is stored partially for 4 to 5 hours, and then it is helps in the secretions of gastric juices. Which are helpful to mix the food properly and digest them by churning process. Now the second organ here you are able to see, that is your large intestine. So in the large intestine, in this picture the B1 is the large intestine and C1 is the small intestine. So large intestine, it is helpful or it is an area where the undigested food it is traveled. When the undigested food it is traveling, water and minerals from the undigested food that are reabsorbed and the food becomes undigested food becomes solidified and it is sent out of the body. When it comes to small intestine, it is an area where the liver juices, pancreatic juices, at the same time intestinal juices are also acting on the food and digesting the food completely. And now the small intestine immediately absorbs the digested food and supplies to all over the body parts. Now the third question, if you will see, in the third question we will see that food travels in only one direction in the digestive system. Explain this statement. Yeah, food always travels only in one direction because some muscular organs that are present are muscular gate-like structures that are present at each and every level of our digestive organs, which are always helpful in preventing. Preventing means stopping the backward movement of the food. So now after the worksheet, now let us see the practice questions. Yes, so in the practice questions, at first they are asking, the chewed food passes from mouth to stomach where it is absorbed into the bladder. It's false. Chewed food passes from mouth to stomach, but it is not absorbed into the blood there only. The large intestine helps in absorbing excess water from the undigested food. This is truly correct. Yes, how do these organs help in the process of digestion? Oesophagus, it is a food pipe which is allowing the passage of food from mouth to stomach by peristaltic movements. The second one is your stomach, where the food is stored for 4-5 hours, where the food it is acted by the gastric juice and by the churning process food is partially digested. Now comes to your large intestine, it is a part where the undigested food particle is traveling. So this large intestine, it reabsorbs the minerals and salts that are present in the undigested food and makes it solidified. And at the rectum region, the undigested food it is stored and it is sent out of the body. Okay children, after completing after watching the video, complete your worksheet and practice questions from the textbook. Thank you so much.